Welcome back to the channel. Today, we have something super exciting for you. We're going to be counting down the top 10 new web series available on all your favorite streaming platforms. So, grab your popcorn and get ready for an incredible lineup of shows. Let's dive right in.
You know, people love this. It's good for you.
Right, this one looks like it's giving me the thumbs up.
Kicking off our list at number 10 is American Born Chinese. Based on the graphic novel of the same name by Jean Lin Yang, American Born Chinese chronicles the trials and tribulations of a regular American teenager whose life is forever changed when he befriends the son of a mythological god. This is the story of a young man's battle for his own identity, told through family, comedy, and action-packed kung fu.
Made a new friend!
Just thought this year was gonna be different.
At number 9, we have A Small Light on Disney Plus. A Small Light, the latest miniseries by Nat Geo, takes a fresh perspective on the Anne Frank saga, zooming in on the remarkable individual who played a pivotal role, Meep Geese, portrayed by Belle Powley. Meep, a close friend and secretary to Otto Frank, played by Liev Schreiber, along with a handful of other courageous individuals, bravely concealed the Frank family from the Nazis for over 2 years. With their creation, Joan Rader and Tony Phelan, known for their work on Grey's Anatomy, beautifully blend a glossy aesthetic with a deeply poignant narrative of resistance, bravery, and the extraordinary risks that ordinary people undertake to preserve their humanity.
So what are you going to tell me?
He's my boss and my friend. What would you have me do when Mr. Frank asked? Say no!
Ask me!
I didn't think I had to consult you before deciding to save a person's life.
There is reason they wanted me. Why me?
Moving on to number 8, we have Queen Charlotte, A Bridgerton Story on Netflix. A Bridgerton Story, the 8-episode prequel centers on a young Queen Charlotte in the 1760s as she forges her path to becoming the powerful crown we know and worship. It also pulls the curtains back for a look inside her marriage to King George, which sparked both a great love story and a societal shift.
About the king. Is he ugly? Perhaps deformed?
He is the king.
Yes. And?
Hello, my lady. Are you in need of assistance of some kind?
If you must know, I'm trying to climb over the garden wall.
Whatever for?
You refuse to help a lady in distress.
I refuse when she's trying to go over a wall so that she does not have to marry me. Hello, Charlotte.
Hello, Angel.
Coming in at number 7 is The Idol on HBO. Get ready to be immersed in the glamorous world of the music industry. This series follows the journey of a talented but struggling musician as he navigates fame, love, and the darker side of the industry. Brace yourself for a roller coaster of emotions. The show will center on Jocelyn, Lily Rose Depp, an aspiring pop idol who, after having a nervous breakdown that causes her last tour to be canceled, resolves to reclaim her title as the sexiest pop star in America and begins a complicated relationship with a self-help guru and the head of a contemporary cult, The Weeknd.
Can I trust you?
Up next, at number 6, we have Citadel on Amazon Prime. This highly anticipated series, created by the Russo brothers, takes us on a global adventure filled with spies, secrets, and thrilling action. With a star-studded cast and a gripping storyline, this show is sure to leave you craving more. A crime syndicate, Manticore, destroys an independent global spy agency that's the last line defense for the good in the world, Citadel, and ambushes its top agents, Nadia Sin and Mason Kane, on a setup mission. As the two escape within an inch of their lives, their memories are erased to safeguard their secrets. 8 years later, a Citadel associate enlists their help to bring Manticore down.
You're gonna wish I was dead.
Ambassador Catherine Wyler, Prime Minister Nicole Trowbridge.
Sliding into the 5th spot, we have The Diplomat on Netflix. This political thriller follows the life of a skilled diplomat caught in a web of international intrigue. With its gripping plot twists and complex characters, this series will keep you guessing until the very end. The Diplomat was just renewed for a second season. Honestly, we can't say we're surprised. With a number one spot on Netflix's top 10 list, the political drama has been a major win for the streamer. The Diplomat follows Kate Wyler, Carrie Russell, a woman hired as an ambassador to the United Kingdom amid an international crisis. As if juggling her career and a pending world war isn't hard enough, her marriage to her husband, Hal, Rufus Sewell, a former political star, is crumbling too. After a stunning 8 episodes, season 1 ended with a bang, leaving Russell's personal and professional life up in the air.
You want my help? You don't want my help. I'm the smartest man you ever met, biggest idiot in the world.
Taking the fourth position is Mrs. Davis on Peacock. After creating massive hits like Lost and HBO's Watchmen, producer Damon Lindelof has another buzzy show on his hands. It's called Mrs. Davis on Peacock, and it might just be one of the wildest shows of 2023. In Reno, Nevada, Sister Simone Gilpin resides in the tranquil Our Lady of the Immaculate Valley Convent, under the care of the kind-hearted Mother Superior, Margot Martindale. Unlike the majority of people, Simone leads an unplugged life, refusing to interact with Mrs. Davis, a powerful AI program that offers constant guidance, structure, and unwavering support through earpieces worn by its users. Blaming the algorithm for her magician father Monty's demise, played by David Arquette, Simone rejects Mrs. Davis's increasingly persistent attempts to connect with her, despite the program's dedicated user base advocating on its behalf. However, Mrs. Davis remains determined and presents Simone with an intriguing proposition. If the nun can locate and destroy the Holy Grail, the algorithm will permanently deactivate itself.
It is only trying to push you into doing what it wants.
What's it like? Always knowing the truth.
Now, at number 3, we have Poker Face. Poker Face is an American crime drama television series created by Rian Johnson for the streaming service Peacock. Poker Face is a murder mystery series stylized as a character-driven, case-of-the-week mystery, with each episode adapting the inverted detective story format popularized by Columbo. The series centers around Charlie Kale, a casino worker with an innate ability to detect lies, traveling across the United States on the run from a casino boss following a suspicious death. Along the way, she encounters colorful characters and solves homicides in a variety of settings.
Red, please.
Look out!
I have been kind of a death magnet.
What if what we see is not what's out there?
Climbing up to the second spot, we have Silo on Apple TV+. This gripping sci-fi series explores a post-apocalyptic world where survivors must navigate a mysterious underground silo. With its atmospheric setting and thought-provoking narrative, this show is bound to leave you wanting more. In a toxic dystopian future where a community exists in a giant silo hundreds of stories deep underground, men and women live in a society full of regulations they believe are meant to protect them.
Packed down to one rule. It's do not say you want to go outside. Or you will go outside.
You came alone. What was the plan?
To kill all of you and then to leave.
And now, with all our guns out?
I'll manage.
And finally, our number one pick for the top new web series is FUBAR on Netflix. This show is good fun. Great casting and solid budget. Production values and writing are outstanding. I hope they make more seasons. When a father, Schwarzenegger, and daughter, Monica Barbaro, learn that they've each secretly been working as CIA operatives for years, they realize their entire relationship has been a lie and they truly don't know one another at all. Forced to team up as partners, the series tackles universal family dynamics set against a global backdrop of spies, action, and humor.
My daughter's in the CIA.
What the f***
in
language?
This place is f***ing
dollar in the swear jar.
I know where the WMD's toward, so follow me or get out of my way.
She clearly has daddy issues.
He treats me like a child.
Alcohol, cigarettes, and the garish lipstick.
That's not lipstick. Oh my God.
It's vibrating, my God.
Kill me now.
Take your daughter to work day is going well.
Emma!
I'm okay, just take him out.
That was her by a lean bomb.
What?